This is James Holder for IFL TV. I'm in the Europa Hotel today in Northern Ireland, Belfast. Just bumped into Gary Spike O'Sullivan. What's up, Miguel?
What's up, lads?
How you doing?
Very good. Yourself?
Good. I'm good. We're here for the Frampton Build today. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Yeah, I say it's a solo crowd. It's going to be a really good night. I think it's going to be a good night for the Irish. Frampton's going to win in style. It's going to be a great win for him. And I'm up to mostly see Steve Orman, my stable mate. And he's got a big fight defending his WBO European title. And I think he's going to win in good fashion. He's up against a good opponent that Kevin Mitchell fought against. And I think that I'm confident Stephen will beat him in better fashion and, you know, go on. And I think it's time that he gets a world title fight for himself, you know. Kevin Mitchell's had the opportunity to fight for 3 world titles now. I think he's going to fight for his 3rd this time, and Steve Orman's not got a chance yet. And I think I think he's better than Kevin Mitchell, and he should be given his opportunity after he wins this fight. It'll be his 3rd time defending his European title in a row, you know, which is good. And you know, I think he really deserves his shot.
Stephen Orman coming off the back of a couple of good wins. Adam Dingsdale plus a great win against Derry Matthews as well, which in truth, he was probably an underdog for that fight. He has earned his shot, hasn't he?
Absolutely, yeah. You know, he went to the Lions then. Derry Matthews, you know, he's good, very good fighter, good puncher. You know, he's very well known on Sky, and you know, he's had some spectacular wins. And Steve Orman beat him very convincingly. And you know, I just think when he does the same tonight or tomorrow night, you know, he should get his chance at world title fight.
What's going on with you? Are you fighting again? Is there any dates or anything you can tell me about?
I'm going to have a fight out in the States in June. I think I'm going to get an opponent maybe next week. It'll be known who it is. I'm sick of kind of looking for fights here at the moment. Chris Eubank Jr., you know, he's running scared. I want to fight him. Everybody knows that.
I've seen quite a lot about your posts on Twitter. You're always bantering him and trying to chase him into a fight. Do you think he wants that fight?
Absolutely not. No, he replies to everybody else. He's like talking about fighting everybody else, but he just won't fight me. You know, he's a chicken. You know, he's afraid to get his same comeuppance as daddy got, from Steve Collins in Cork, where I'm from. And you know, I think he knows that it'd be the same fate would await him if he took the fight with me. And you know, it's just one that he doesn't want. He's running, you know, and he's getting terrible abuse on Twitter. And you know, no matter how much abuse he gets, he still won't reply. You know, he's just a big chicken, really. You know, he should just give up boxing. And you know, he's more of a poser, you know.
As opposed to you, as you're all in action, kind of ready to fight, ready to go to work kind of guy, aren't you?
Absolutely, yeah. You've seen me fight before a couple of times, you know, and you know, I think completely different guy altogether to Chris Eubank. You know, he doesn't interact with his fans on Twitter, like, even though he's got like 85,000 followers. You know, he never really subscribes back to anybody or, you know, gives any feedback to people, just talking a lot of crap, really. So he's an absolute poser and not really a boxer.
Do you find that quite frustrating?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I do, of course. Yeah, you know, if he wants to box, he should just, you know, fight people who want to fight him, and especially the fans want to see it. You know, every time there's any bit of banter on Twitter about me fighting Chris, there's an awful lot of interest, an awful lot of retweets. I think one of them got like around 700,000 hits. You know, it's a fight that will sell very, very easily. You know, it's a no-brainer, and we really should get it on. You know, Chris, come on, grow up here, man,
first.
Grow up here.
You heard it here first. You've got a fantastic record, Gary, suffering the only one defeat against Billy Joe Saunders. I was at that fight. Again, it's a great fight. Come through some good wins as well, Matthew Hall, to get you in that spot. What's the reason for your inactivity? Looking at your record, you've 17 fights, 16 wins. Surely you're a bit of a draw in this country as well. What's going on here?
I am not too sure. I've actually asked to fight quite a few fighters, you know, and none of them seem interested in fighting with me. You know, I'm kind of a big puncher, you know, and the fight I really want is Chris Eubank, and you know, he's not willing to have that fight. So I think it's time to go to the States now. I'm going to go with the Dropkick Murphys. We're tied in with Golden Boy Promotions, and they promised to get me a few fights and keep me busy. So that's what I need now. You know, I'm 29, and you know, I want to be as active as possible, and you know, reach my destiny and become the champion of the world.
29?
29, yeah.
Same age as me. God, you look older than me.
That's what happens when you're taking punches in the gym every day of the week, you know. So
I'm joking. I'm
better looking though, right?
I've got a face for radio myself. I can't say much, you know what I mean?
I know. That's why you're behind the camera and I'm front, right?
Indeed. So am I right in thinking you're going to be relocating to the States, or is it just a one fight and then you'll be back? What is the plan and thinking behind that?
No, initially, no, I'm going to have a guaranteed 2 fights. So yeah, I'm going to be relocating to the States. I've been doing a lot of training out there, but I'm going to be remaining in the Celtic Warrior gym. So I'll be to and fro. I'm going to, Pascal Collins is going to be my trainer, you know, continue to be my trainer. And it was just really a change of promotions, really. I'm going to go with the Dropkick Murphys, Murphy USA Promotions, and fight out of the States from now.
Irish boxers are so well regarded in the States, with a big population of Irish people there. Do you feel you get more love in the States than you maybe do in England?
I'm not sure. I think the English are good as well. It's good to fight in England. I like fighting in England. I fought in London like 3 times. I enjoyed that experience. It was really good. And in Boston, there is a big Irish community, but there's a big one in London as well. But I'm looking forward to going to Boston. There's a big Cork community out there as well, for where I'm from.
Yeah.
I see John Evan fought out there recently, and the House of Blues, and he got a great reception out there, And I fought there twice as well before myself, I found it really good out there, I'm looking forward to going back there to fight. Can't wait.
Cork people from Cork, very, very good people, very reputable, very straight. I found people from Cork as well, though. They won't beat around the bush in their thinking. Do you think that's fair?
Definitely very fair to say, absolutely. Like, we're very straight about where the real capital of Ireland is, from Cork, even though the Dubs think they're the real capital, but we're very straight that way, definitely.
Well, listen, I appreciate you giving me a bit of time today.
My pleasure.
I will be watching how you get on in the States with great interest, and I hope that we get to see you fighting in our shores a little bit more,
Hopefully with a bit of luck, get a few good wins under my belt out in the States, and pick up a title, maybe hopefully the world title, and come back and defend it, and when I do win the world title, the first guy I give the defence to is Chris Eubank,
Is that for real?
Definitely. Yeah. If I become the champion of the world, when I become the champion of the world, I'm going to come home, defend it against you, Chris Eubank, and if you don't even fight me then, which you probably won't, I might even beat you up with the belt, give me a few slaps of it.
Oh, you're a bad fella.
And he deserves it, doesn't he?
This is Spike. I really appreciate giving me a bit of time today. I hope the fight with you and Chris Eubank does get made, because it's got a lot of spite and venom in it already. So
absolutely, yeah. So final message to Chrissy is stop hiding, Chrissy. Stop hiding, Chris. Chrissy, fight me.
This is James Helder with Spike O'Sullivan for IFL TV. Thank you very much.